Welcome, you're watching the News Hour Agenda. I'm Padmaja Joshi. It was a rather bad beginning to the weekend for some people in Uttar Pradesh. The Yogi government came up with a new and a rather curious way of countering those accused of rioting during the anti-CAA protests in the state. Hoardings with their names, addresses and photos went up across the city. Now, these people have been asked to pay up for the damage to public property, failing which, their property would be attached. Now, this move has started a massive debate over whether this is an attempt to try and carry out a witch hunt against the people against whom even the trial in the cases has not started. The accused say they have already received the recovery notices of 1 crore 55 lakh rupees. The police knows where they stay. The case is already with the police. Then what is the purpose of these posters except to carry out a public trial, a mob hunt, a witch hunt of sorts against them?
और एनआरसी विरोधी आंदोलनकारियों का तस्वीर जिस तरह इस भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार ने चौराहों पर लगाने का काम किया है, निश्चित रूप से यह पूरी तरह गैर कानूनी है। उनके चरित्र की हनन और आपराधिक षड्यंत्रकारी की राजनीति पूरी तरह इस सरकार ने करने का काम किया है। उनके खिलाफ कमजोर सबूत भी नहीं दे पाई। उन लोगों का नाम पोस्टर अपराधियों की तरह किस तरह शहर में चस्पा करने का काम इस सरकार ने किया है।
Alright, so is this the government trying to carry out a witch hunt, a public shaming of those against whom the charges have still not been proven? Or is this a Yogi model to deal with rioters that could be replicated across the country? Let's find out. Joining us on the panel, we have Shazia Elmi of the Bharatiya Janata Party, activist Sushil Pandit. We've got Mr. Tasleem Ahmed Rehmani, senior journalist Ashutosh. And we have got Syed Aslam Pasha of the JDS. Let me start by asking you, Shazia Elmi, when the case is going to be tried eventually, what's the purpose of these posters? Even the accused are saying the police knows our name, the police knows our address. Then what's the point of this public shaming, Shazia Elmi? All right, I don't think Shazia Elmi is through with us just as yet. But Ashutosh, if you destroy public property, you pay up and be ready for public shaming as well. You agree with this logic?
No. Let me tell you, this is a blatantly anti-democratic, anti-constitution. This is a violation of the judicial system. And this is a classic case of contempt of court. The Allahabad High Court, in last week, if I remember correctly, in a similar case, has said that UP government has no right to go for the wasooli because it is beyond their domain. The Supreme Court order very categorically has written long back that state government has no right on this. It is the court matter. The court appoints a judge. Judge is assisted by an assessor. And this assessor who makes an assessment of the property damaged, and accordingly he reports back to the judge, and then judge decides what should be the amount. So it is beyond the jurisdiction of the executive.
So then, Sushil Pandit, is the Yogi government trying to be all of this, judge, jury, executioner?
It's a classic case of contempt of court.
It's a contempt of court, what the Yogi government is doing. Sushil Pandit.
Yes.
No, I think it is a government's duty to make sure that those who damage public property, those who indulge in violence, those who risk lives and the property of the state and personal property must face the consequences. If government does anything, you raise questions. If the government doesn't do anything, then you are ready to condemn the government. It's a case of damned if you do and damned if you don't.
Syed Aslam Pasha.
And therefore, I think UP government must be commended.
So there is no need of
this.
Mr. Pandit,
may be unprecedented.
Mr. Pandit, this
but
is a blot. This looks like a.
That
this
has
is, this looks
that
like
UP
a black, black mark on the law and order,
the last 2 months,
right?
As you saw
if the CM cannot decide, the CM cannot decide and public shame people wherever you don't have a trial started. Wherever they have,
and the
wherever
there
is a trial not started, are we living in a medieval age? Are we living in a medieval age? Are we living in some banana republic? Are we living in some anarchy that there is nothing called law and order? How can the honorable chief minister take a decision to publicly shame the Reuters, the so-called Reuters? It is not even, the trial is, has not even started.
But,
are you
but
doing,
shouldn't
you,
this outrage
you will do
be
the trial
directed,
in
sir,
public,
at those who are burning public property rather than those who are
people.
Trying to recover the money for it, Mr. Syed Aslam Pasha? Isn't the anger
yes,
a little misdirected?
Well, of course, Padmaja, of course,
Padmaja.
If something...
I have a
well, Padmaja, of course, if someone has done something wrong, there is law to take care of it. The law will take its own course. It is not the police, it is not the chief minister, or it is not the public who will decide what is wrong.
There is
adjudicate
on issues where disagreements happen. But
there
as far
is something
as policy is concerned,
system.
As far as administration
if you think
is
that you are living in some anarchy,
is
I am sorry.
It is the remit of the government.
We have
it
a constitution to follow. We have democracy in this nation. We have democracy in this nation.
And government
and democracy will certainly...
No, but tell me this. Is it illegal, sir? Is it illegal, Ashutosh? What has been done? Is it illegal? It is in the government's purview to say, listen... We want 1 crore 55 lakhs. Please pay up. आपको recovery notice
Absolutely.
दिया था. आपने पैसा नहीं दिया है. दीजिए पैसा. ये लोग हैं. इन्होंने पैसा नहीं दिया है.
No, Padmaja. First of all, it has to be proved that they are guilty. They have to be convicted by the court. And it is the court's jurisdiction to appoint a claim commissioner. And it is the claim commissioner. Who will be assisted by an SSC?
When there is a traffic challan, is it after conviction in the court?
Around the city, none of them have been found guilty. And those
if there is a traffic challan, is it after the court convicts?
They are supporting a criminal government. Those who are supporting, they are supporting a criminal government, and this government needs to be sacked.
Shazia Elmi.
This government is not working according to the
constitution.
You know, can
you imagine the charge is the Yogi government is acting ultra vires of the law. They are acting like judge, jury, executioner.
This government is
case register nahi hua, unka poster chhap diya. Shazia Elmi.
That is not true. And can I...
This country is not a banana republic.
Can you ask others to...
This country is not a banana republic.
Because I've just got my chance to speak. First of all, I would like to say that if it's my personal property and anybody vandalizes it, I have every right to go out there and seek damages. When is public property, roads, buildings, offices, schools, it is public property. It is there and maintained with our money. We have our stake in that. And the chief minister of a state is the CEO, is the chief administrator. Surely we have to teach people not to break and not to damage public property or personal property. Just because it belongs to the state does not mean...
No, but Ashutosh
right
is saying this is illegal. It is contempt
and
of
yes,
court.
The courts must maintain...
And in Uttar Pradesh only there have been cases where such charges have been thrown out by the court.
There has to be identification of those and ensure it does not have to do with any religion. It does not have to do with any party. It does not have to do with any side. So I would like to request all those sitting there, please do not make it about BJP or Congress or Samajwadi Party. Please see what damage this is doing, this mentality to regular citizens who do not want to be a part of
Padmaja.
This protest or violence. That they deserve.
Okay, just stay with me, Ashutosh, because you know we are also wondering what people
Padmaja.
Think about it, because we're talking about public property here. Does the public share the outrage or does the public agree with this measure? Let me bring in Akhil, a viewer who's calling in right now. Go in, Akhil.
Hi.
Yes, hi.
Good evening, Padmaja.
Good evening.
Yeah, see, I would like to make a point to Ashutosh here. He's saying that Yogi has gone over the court to put these photos. Now, whenever people are wanted by the police or they leave the court hearing or something and run away in between, their photos are also put up. They are just charged. Nowhere they are already convicted. So is that also going above the court?
Okay, no. your question is to Ashutosh. I'll put it to him. And let me also bring in Ashwin. Thanks very much, Akhil. Ashwin, another viewer is with me on the line. Go on, Ashwin.
Yeah, Padmaja, it is very simple here, right? If they put these posters on the street, that these are the people who are vandalized, irrespective of the caste, religion or anything, right? Then that means Yogi government has some proof on these people that they did vandalism and destroyed the public property. If not, it is the onus of these people to prove that they have not done anything, right? That
no, but sir, the law says innocent until proven guilty. You are reversing it. Many would argue this is ulta. That somebody accuses you, names and shames you, and then says, now prove it that you are innocent.
They have damaged the public property. It is not a civil case. Right? It is not a civil case. They have damaged the public property, and they are owners, they are owners on these people to prove that they did not do it. So okay. It is absolutely fair to put these people's name on the board and let them prove that they have not done it. I mean, they can always go to the court and say, I did not
okay,
do it.
Okay, Mr. Rehmani, answer these two people. They are saying that you had absolutely no compunctions when you are out there destroying public property, you know, making videos while you are doing it, going on Facebook Live, then why the outrage now, Mr. Rehmani?
You see, first of all, the first caller, he said that the police stations, the police also displays the pictures of those people who are culprits or
who are wanted, yes.
Yes, the police do it. But all those people are either absconding or at large. That's why those pictures are being pasted on the police stations, etc. They are the wanted people. While in this case, they are not the wanted people. They are well within the public domain. Some of them are already arrested and are out on bail. So these pictures need not, that does not come under that purview. Secondly, this public property, yes. Whosoever is damaging the public property must be arrested and must repay the damages. But then, first, it has to be proved that really they were. Do you want to say that this Sadaf has burned any school or any hospital, or SR Dharapuri has burned? Do you have any proof?
Most of these people are well regarded. Sadaf Jafar is an activist. SR Dharapuri is a former IPS officer. Then why shame them like this, Sushil Pandit?
Yes. And you are trying to paint those activists like a criminal? Do you have any proof that they were damaging? And what about those police personnel who are equally...
Or is it a fear tactic?
And there are...
Let Sushil Pandit answer. Is this basically a fear tactic?
Will you post their pictures as well? Will you display their pictures as well?
Sushil Pandit.
Isn't that they are doing these things without any proof or evidence? They have gathered evidence. They have zeroed in on specific identities. It is only basis this evidence that they have moved ahead and sought damages from them. It is pretty much
SR Dharapuri shooting the people or burning the property or throwing the stone.
Done it and
can you show me any picture of SR Dharapuri or Trap or Sadaf? Can you show me?
And it is basis that if they have a problem, they can go to the court.
I challenge you. I challenge you, Mr. Sushant. I challenge you. Can you show me one picture where SR Dharapuri is throwing a stone or burning the properties? Show me.
In case of criminal offenses, this is a civil liability. This is not a criminal offense. And in civil liability, a government has a right.
Of vandalizing act.
And especially if
otherwise,
they have
I can show you the UP police, which is shooting the people.
Sayed Islam.
I can show you the evidences where the UP police is shooting the innocent protesters.
I just want to ask
the peaceful protesters. I can show you those claims.
I just want to ask Ms. Shazia Ilmi and Mr. Pandit, right? Tomorrow, any officer on personal vendetta picks up some suspect, does it mean that we'll put the posters across the city and then we'll start the trial? It's absolutely ridiculous. It cannot. So we are saying that Kapil Mishra has instigated violence in Delhi. So there should be a case booked against him. There should be an FIR against him. Does it mean that we'll put posters of Kapil Mishra across the city?
Now,
there are so many posters which have been put, so many photos have been put with the address. these people's lives are at risk.
Kapil
they
Mishra
have
has been
mentioned
named
in these photos.
It
becomes so vulnerable
about,
and dangerous for
so
them
by
to
the
live.
Same logic,
who is responsible for this dangerous act?
Who were very
who is
proud
responsible
to show
for this dangerous
how against
act?
They are. And you know, the strange thing about this whole argument is that it's all about the citizenship stir. The fear of losing citizenship. What kind of responsible citizenship?
Well, ma'am,
and
this
the
is not the way you can
this,
curb citizenship.
The of it is
we
when
are
you want
protesting
to vandalize the property of
we
your
are
own
protesting
state,
against CAA.
Of which you want to be
this is
very
an
much
act,
a part of
you are just trying to
so
threaten people.
So I find it very
people,
ironical
you are just trying
that on the
to
one hand
you're
fighting for
do not protest against
and on
CAA.
The other hand you want to destroy
not, you
property,
cannot stop people from protesting against CAA like this.
And show your anger.
You cannot threaten the people will not get scared.
I mean, if I go to your house and I'm angry, can I break things in your house?
Or
and obviously there is evidence against me. Why should I mind if there are posters? People are very proud to be there. Hmm. People are very proud when they're talking about it and tweeting
only
it and
when
talking
there is
about the right
only
to be
when
out
there is
there.
Evidence
so surely they
them.
Would enjoy
it. Only when
the
there
posters,
is evidence
they would
against
become
them.
Poster.
The trial
they would become literally the poster boys.
Hmm.
Of the
Ashutosh. Ashutosh. So Shadia Elmi says if you are happy to be a poster boy of the movement, well, you are on a poster there. Why are you upset now? You wanted to be poster boys? You've got posters.
No, Padmaja.
Yeah, exactly.
My simple,
my simple argument is,
ask Shazia Ilmi and the BJP
and now you're very
to throw,
acting very
to throw
about, the
constitution
posters.
In some dustbin.
I mean, that's hypocrisy
as long as the
of the highest kind.
As long as the constitution is valid, as long as we swear by the constitution, as long as we talk about the constitution, the country and the state and the government will run according to the constitution. It not that anybody, any Shazia Ilmi, any Yogi Adityanath will suddenly will stand up and say, no, you are guilty, so you are punished, then you will be shot here.
Now suddenly
this
it's
is, this
the
is
country
anarchy.
And the government.
This is anarchy.
And
this is this is a case of fascism.
For which people
this is a clear-cut case of fascism.
How about that?
That you will not accept high court order. You will not accept Supreme Court. You will not accept
not
constitution. Suddenly you will come up and decide you are the people who are guilty and you should be punished. What logic is this?
Are we
going towards a jungle raj or what?
Who pay taxes to maintain?
Padmaja, I want to remind you. Padmaja, I want to remind you.
The colleges.
Last month.
The roads, the
last
fences.
Month, a citizen from the Kanpur,
I mean,
who participated in the anti-CA riot, he was served a notice for this damages. He had gone to the Allahabad High Court. Allahabad High Court has given him a relief, has served a notice to the UP government. And he said that you can't do it because matter is already decided by the Supreme Court. Now the Yogi government
so you're
has
on thin
no
ice.
Respect for the Supreme Court. Has no respect for the constitution.
So Sushil Pandit, this is on very thin ice. This is on very thin ice, but you're playing with fire because you want to put the fear of God in people.
Padmaja, can you imagine? This man is displaying basic ignorance. You know, district magistrates have quasi-judicial powers. This is not about imprisoning someone. This is not about declaring someone guilty to sentence him to certain days, months and years. This is about fixing civil liability. This is about fixing damages, which is pretty much within the remit of a district magistrate. However, judicial remedies are available. Just as somebody went to the High Court or Sessions Court in order to get these charges waived off, just as we go for our traffic offences to the court and say, no, this is not admissible, they
can
always go.
There is no
it
hope
is
in this
wrong
country.
To say that an administration
there is no hope in this country.
Should
abdicate
why? Its responsibility and ask the courts to run the country, even in terms of picking up civil
no,
damages, even in terms of civil liability for
the
acts
that is exactly,
of omission and commission
exactly
by those who have filmed
Thakur
themselves, who have pictured themselves, who have taken
is,
videos
if,
and who are pretty
are,
much
see,
there
if,
as evidence
Sushar,
doing these
if
things.
This act is being justified, if this act is being justified by fellow panelists, then I lose hope. Seriously, I lose hope.
They are actually endorsing what Arora Thakur has said during the Delhi campaign.
So fascism, banana republic, there is no hope left for this country. Prem from Delhi, another viewer. Yes, Prem, what do you think? Is this fascism?
Well, madam, I'm listening to all the leftist characters on your show. They come and they talk about constitution, they talk about rule of law, they talk about the court, they talk about all these things. You have one of the characters called Harshmandar. He has been going to the Shaheen Bagh and giving all sorts of speeches there and instigating all these elements, antisocial elements, and all the people who are talking against that the court. We will not listen to Supreme Court's judgment. We will, the government cannot decide. We will decide on the road. Sonia Gandhi says.
So, sir, what's your point? What's your point? How are these posters related to all of that?
Nonsense. Do they care for the people of this country at that time? When they go on their rampage, they go on killing the innocent policemen and they cause all sorts of destruction and damage. This is an international conspiracy going on.
Okay, so Taseem Ahmed Rehmani, interesting point being made by the gentleman here. Aap kehte hain faisla sadak par hoga. तो उसका जवाब भी सड़क पर मिलेगा जब सड़क पर पोस्टर लगेगा तो फिर हर चीज ही सड़क पर कीजिए आपको तो सड़क पर फैसला चाहिए ना
पद्मजा व्हाट एग्जैक्टली यूपी गवर्नमेंट इज डूइंग इज लाइक द लाइक व्हाट यूपी गवर्नमेंट इज एग्जैक्टली डूइंग इज द स्लोगन
कॉइंड बाय आवर यूनियन मिनिस्टर अनुराग ठाकुर आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई दिस कॉइन इज
ये कौम के गद्दारों को गोली मारो सालों को से दे वांट टू बाईपास द जुडिशियल सिस्टम दे वांट टू बाईपास
द पोस्टर लगाना इक्वल टू गोली मारना
एवरी अदर टूल एंड इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑफ गवर्नेंस एंड दे वांट टू टेक देयर ओन डिसीजंस लाइक व्हाट द अनुराग ठाकुर सेड इन दिल्ली You take the decision.
नहीं, but पोस्टर लगाना और गोली मारने को इक्वेट करना थोड़ा सा ज्यादा नहीं हो गया
But what did people do?
It is like that.
People from Aam Aadmi Party who actually carrying guns. What about that?
People's lives are so vulnerable.
He's talking about it worse than actually carrying guns. You are defaming people from Aam Aadmi Party.
Anytime.
Kapil Gujjar fellow.
Shazia
Almi, the point here is you have endangered their person. Tomorrow, anyone accused of anything, their name, address is put up on public posters. Koi bhi unko attack kar sakta hai. Tomorrow, somebody could go to their house, attack them.
Bilkul.
Says Mr. Rehmani.
And we have seen exactly what had happened in Delhi. Who are the attackers?
Everywhere on social media, they're proud to be leading this. They're very happy. And I think they want to be the poster boys. So I don't think they Why should feel coy being actually on the posters.
The Constitution has given us the right to protest.
They come and quote that they are happy by putting posters on these streets
protesting against something which is discriminatory. The Constitution has given us the right. Article 19 has given us the right to protest. Is it something wrong to protest against CAA? Doesn't mean whatever the government brings in, the people have to agree. We are not living in anarchy.
You know what, if I don't know. I hope I don't become the CM because I would have a huge problem.
Is right to protest also
walls.
Right to destroy property?
I have a
property.
Huge problem who use walls to urinate. I think there should be a
no,
way.
No, definitely not. Let the law take its course.
Who destroys?
You are doing a trial on the road. Let the law take its own course.
If someone is wrong,
let the law take its course. Let them be punished. What if this photo?
Which religion? Which sign is here?
What if this poster has been put on in Lucknow? And what if this person is clean? He comes out clean.
What would you do?
You're angry, so you want to make a deep break.
Ashutosh, I want to ask you the general consensus of people who are even calling in the public, whose opinion we are hearing here is that at least now people will think twice before taking the law in their hands. They will be scared of this public shaming. Nobody can think that they are going to shoot and scoot anymore. The means might be dubious, the ends are effective.
Who will be responsible if somebody is hurt by the mob?
Yeah, Ashutosh.
This country will be run by the court trial or by the public trial? No. I want to ask a simple question. This country will be run by the public trial or by the court trial? Then let's abandon all the courts. Why we are going to the court? Let's get every kind of people on the road and shoot them.
That for you. He'll answer that. You believe in him.
Shoot them there.
Why are you asking us the question?
I'll try because we've got a lot of viewers calling in right now. I want to give one last word to one of our viewers, Mr. Mukherjee, calling from Ghaziabad. Yes, Mr. Mukherjee, can this be effective or it's very thin when it comes to legality? Mr. Mukherjee.
You see, the legality part is defined all through. The law is defined on the act of people, the act of circumstances and everything. So if the circumstances forces the chief minister to take certain actions against the rioters, the law or the rule cannot really overpower what actually is happening.
Mm.
And the panelists are thinking that Jogi has done wrong. They are in terms encouraging in mass to create riots and vandalize and get free.
Okay.
Am I clear?
Okay. Thanks very much, Mr. Mukherjee, for calling in. In conclusion, I'll say just this, that on the legality of what has happened, there can be only one way for it to be decided. Anyone who is on that poster should go to court. That is exactly what happened in Allahabad. A man was served notice. He got relief from the court. And if what has been done by the Yogi government is not legal, then let the court decide it. The fact still remains that these are people who've been told 1 crore 55 lakh rupees of our money has been burnt in these riots. Pay up or the next step is not going to be posters. Your property is going to be attached. For now, thanks very much for joining me on Debate Number 1.